long time ago, my mother was hit by a drunk driver head on. We brought her home 3 months after being in the hospital. We brought her home to live in our living room with, we set our living room up as a hospital. We had the hospital bed, we had the feeding tubes, we had everything. So after doing that, and she went and started living back in her own house, we wanted to continue helping. So our first thought was, let's help children.
We started looking into foster care and we found a spare net. And so we joined forces with them. Ever since then, it's been an amazing working relationship.
SparaNet works with families who are willing to open up their home for kids who have come into the foster care system. And that runs from anywhere from a couple weeks to a couple months up to a couple years while their birth families are trying to take the steps necessary to provide a loving and secure home for their kids to return to.
The best part of going through a SparaNet is they're always there. We can pick up the phone call away.
Once a child is placed in the foster home of a SparaNet, a social worker is assigned to go into the home once a week and check on the kids, check on the families to make sure that everything is being provided for that child. We will make sure that they get medical appointments and get them to their schools, get them to their visits with their birth families.
Our son was our very first placement. The SparaNet got a call that they had a boy who was deaf, and both of us are ASL fluent, and so it was the perfect opportunity. And we've since then finalized our adoption, and we've continued to foster.
Well, I've actually had a long period of time where I've worked with Teresa and Rosemary. They do such good work with the kids. One of the things I really like about them is that they kind of tailor the way they interact and parent the kids to each child's needs. So it's not just a one size fits all for them. And you can really see the kids respond to that, and they just blossom as soon as they're here.
We had another deaf kid who stayed with us for a short period of time. So we've been able to kind of use our special skill set other than just with our son. Actually, one of the kids came to us and they thought it was going to be a special needs case. Perhaps a special educational plan was going to be needed and intensive speech therapy. And after just 1 month with us, he was already talking and signing.
My mom lives nearby. She lives down the street. One thing now with the kids coming and going, it actually brightens my mom's day because she gets to meet all of them, see all of them, get to be a part of their life, part of their success.
The coolest thing about being a foster parent is that we do get to see these kids come in and maybe be timid or unsure because it's a brand new environment and they have no idea what's happening. Their whole world has been turned upside down. And then we get to just show them the love and care that they need when they're separated from their families. And in the best case scenario, like recently, we had a child who was reunified with family. And over the last 4 months, we built up a relationship with that family and just learned everything about their family culture, what the child, you know, needed and what they did with their family. And we saw a really cool turnaround. So we got to interact with mom and support and provide just reassurance. And that was the happiest reunion that we've seen thus far. It was really cool.
With the SparaNet, we really encourage our foster families to form a connection or a bond with the birth family. It helps the birth family in as they're going through their process of trying to get their children to return home to them. It also helps with the youth while they're out of their birth parents' home, that they can feel supported by their foster parents to know that they really want to do what they can to help them return back to their families.
It's extremely difficult to have somebody come and be a part of your family and then know that at any one point that family member's going to be leaving. But on the other side of that, it's really positive knowing that if a reunification happens, it's in the best interest of the child. And so you just part ways knowing that you did something for them and that they're happy and loved.